We are going to solve Project Euler problem 41 already. So the problem statement first tells us what a pentadigital number is. So n digit number is pentadigital if it makes use of the digits 1 to n exactly once. What's the largest n digit pentadigital prime that exists? So in order to solve this, I copied the isPrime function that we used in problem number 7. If you are interested in why that works, you can check out problem number 7. And well, let's just go ahead and implement the solution. I'm going to have a list that's called pentadigital primes, which is just a list of integers, which are all the pentadigital primes, of which we need to find the largest one. Pentadigital primes can be defined as follows. Now that's going to be a little bit complicated. The basic idea is that we, first of all, take all permutations of the digits 1 to 9 and find out which of those are primes. If there are no primes in those numbers, we're going to check out the permutations of 1 to 8 and then check for primes in them, and so on until we found some prime numbers. So let's have all these lists. We are going to have the list of digits of 1 up to n, and we choose our n to be first 9, because this will give us the largest numbers, then 8, and so on down to 1. Of course, we will never reach 1, because there are certainly pentadigital primes before the number 1, but yeah. Now, for each of these digit sets of digits that we have right here, we are going to do the following. First of all, we need all permutations of these numbers. So we're going to map onto this list of lists the permutations function. Permutations. This is defined in the standard library in data.list, and will give us all permutations of a given list. So let's map permutations onto those. And now we basically have a list of integers for each of these lists. Now we want this individual lists of digits to be, well, numbers that we can where we can find out if they are prime or not. So let's do this. We define a function that is called int list to int, and of course this will take an integer list and return an integer. Now we will do this via fold l. So we're just going to do fold l, iterating over the digits from left to right. And for each digit that we encounter, we're going to add those digits to our accumulated value, which we need to multiply by 10 because we moved one step forward. So just like that. Of course, we can use the strict version for bonus efficiency, so to speak. And we'll use that right here. So we're going to map int list to int over all the permutations. So we actually have numbers that are pentadigital. Now we're going to filter those according to if they are prime or not. So we're just going to do a filter with the predicate is prime. And afterwards, we need to find out the maximum of these pentadigital primes that we have here. So of course, it could be the case that in the one through nine pentadigital numbers, there are no primes at all. So we need a function that only maybe returns the maximum. Unfortunately, there is no such function in the Haskell standard library. So I'm just going to call this maximum maybe, which I need to define. Maximum maybe takes a list of integers and returns maybe an integer. And if we are given the empty list, so if there is no prime, then we return nothing. But if there is a list, then we just take the usual maximum of this list. Of course, wrapped in a just value, maximum excess. So now that we have for each of the n's, the largest 1 through n pentadigital prime, we need to convert this list of maybe values into a list of, well, just integers. We can achieve this by doing cat maybes, which of course we need to import from data.maybe. And now that we have that, we can define the main function. And this one is quite simple. We just print the head of the pentadigital primes, because of course they are sorted according to their value, because we iterated from 9 to 1 right here. So let's go ahead and compile this. And run it with time. And as you see, this gives us the correct result in 0.07 seconds. Thanks for watching.